Hello everyone, this is Abhinesh Krishna and welcome to my another video. I hope everyone is doing good and happy Diwali to everybody. And so in today's video, I'm going to share some information about essential skills work visa to residency based on skill migrant category. So basically, if you're an essential skills work visa, so like say for example, if you need to get an essential skills work visa as a student, what else you need to do? So as a student, first thing you need to do is like find a job which is related to your field or like where your background of study is related to it. And once you find a job, the first option you need to go is through essential skills work visa. Try to apply for an essential skills work visa based on your pay rate. Say to apply for an essential skills work visa, you need to get around $26 per hour to get a 3 years work visa, and it will be around mid-skill category. So basically that's the first option you need to do. And once you're in 3 years of work visa, like you need to try to enter into skill migrant category so as to get into residency. So that's what the process is about. So as a student without any skills, you won't be able to apply for residency directly. So the best thing to go for is using your post-study work visa, try to search for a job which is related to your field, or if you have a background of experience or something, you can get a job in that certain field, but it should come under skill shortage list. Only then you will be able to apply for residency or go through the pathway to residency. So once you're able to get a find a job with a permanent job contract and everything, like you can apply for a essential skills work visa, which is mid-skill category. And once you're able to get a mid-skill category essential skills work visa, then after 2 years of essential skills work visa, try to go for skill migrant category, where you can apply for residency based on your points. For the points, like you should work outside Auckland and you should earn around 160 points. And currently, if you are working outside Auckland and you're earning around 26 per hour, and like you do have 2 years of work experience in New Zealand, you can go for skilled migrant category visa, where you will get around 160 points, and you can also apply for residency. So that's the only option for students. As a student without any experience, this would be the process. First, get a job using your post-study work visa, and then apply for mid-skill essential work visa. You should be, there are low-skill and mid-skill jobs. Based on that, you can get an essential skills work visa, but mid-skill will get you through 3 years of work visa, where you can apply for residency based on skill category level after 2 years of study. So that's what the information which I thought of sharing in this video. So if you have any questions or comments, just leave it down below this video. I will make a video or directly answer your questions. See you soon in another video. Bye bye.